प्रेम सुषमापति महादेव की जय। पवन सुत हनुमान की जय। ब्यूटीफुल श्री हनुमान जी आरती। ओम श्री गणेशाय नमः। ओम श्री सरस्वत्यै नमः। ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमो नमः। ओम नमः शिवाय। ओम नमः शिवाय। आरती की जय। हनुमान लाकी दुष्ट दलन रघुनाथ कलाकी। आरती की जय। हनुमान लाकी दुष्ट दलन रघुनाथ कलाकी। आरती की जय। हनुमान लाकी दुष्ट दलन रघुनाथ कला। जाके बल से गिरिवर कापे रोग दोष जाके निकटन जाके। जाके बल से गिरिवर कापे रोग दोष जाके निकटन जाके। अंजनी 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 पुत्र महाबलदाई संतन के प्रभु सदा सहाय। देवी रघुनाथ पताए लंका जारी सिया सुधिलाए। देवी रघुनाथ बताए लंका जारी सिया सुधिलाए। लंका से लंका से गोत समुद्र से काये जात पवन सुत बादल लाए। लक्ष्मण मूरचित पदे सकारे आनी संजीवन प्राण उबारे। लक्ष्मण मूरचित पदे सकारे आनी संजीवन प्राण उबारे। पताल तोरे जमकारे अहिरावण के भुजा उचार। जय बजरंग बले। सुन नर मुनि आरती जय 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 हनुमान उचारे। ओम श्री हनुमते नमः। सुन नर मुनि आरती उतारे जय 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 हनुमान उचारे। कंचन 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 तारक पुर आरती करत अंजना मारे। जय श्री हनुमान। की जय, आरती की जय, हनुमान लला की, दुशरा लला रघुनाथ कला की। As you pay our salutations, O Lord Hanuman Ji, persistence, O Lord, on this beautiful night, the fifth night of our 25 nights of Sri Hanuman Ji Yatra, keep your persistence, adoration, salutations to His lotus-like form. Jai 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 Hanuman, Jai 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 Hanuman, Jai 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 Hanuman, Jai 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 Hanuman. Just a little bit of salt, take our seats. As we begin this beautiful afternoon in devotion to our Lord, on this beautiful afternoon, this beautiful night, the fifth night of our 25 nights of Sri Hanumanji Yatra, we take this beautiful opportunity to say once more cordial welcome, namaskar, swagatam to each and everyone on behalf of this wonderful home and this beautiful family, this divine parivar. We say swagatam to the members of the Celestial Gandharvas who have accompanied me once more to receive that blessing and to once more deliver the energy to each and everyone. We say swagatam to all us, all of them. To all bhaktas and all devotees who are hailing from far and near, to all those who are streaming live, to all those who are viewing via 103.1 FM, and to all the Facebookers who are tuned in, we specially welcome you to our beautiful Yajna as we take this moment to touch the feet of none other than Mahavira Swami. At this time, devotees, without further ado, let us all take this moment to sit upright. As we close our eyes and we focus our thoughts on Mahavira Swami. He's called Panchmukhi Hanumanji, five faces, five forms, in that one body that He creates. And as we glorify Him, we begin with Omkar three times.
महाकाय सूर्यकोटि समप्रभा निर्विघ्नं कुरु मे देवा सर्वकादिषु सर्वदा सरस्वती नमोस्तुभ्यं वरदे कामरूपिणी विद्यारम्भं करिष्यामि सिद्धि भवतु मे सदा। या देवी सर्वभूतेषु दुर्गारूपेण संस्थिता नमस्तस्य नमो नमः। या देवी सर्वभूतेषु लक्ष्मीरूपेण संस्थिता नमस्तस्य नमो।
या देवी सर्वभूतेषु सरस्वतीरूपेण संस्थिता नमस्तस्य नमो नमः। नमस्तस्य नमस्तस्य
नमस्तस्य नमो नमः। तू ही हमका ओ संभाले, तू ही हमारे रखवारे, तुमरे बिन हमरा कौन नहीं, तुमरे बिन हमरा कौन नहीं। ओ पालन भारे निरौन और न्यारे, ओ पालन भारे निरौन और न्यारे, तुमरे बिना हमरा कौन नहीं, तुमरे बिना हमरा कौन नहीं।
To the Lord of life, to the sustainer of the entire cosmos,
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna Hare Hare, Hare Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama Hare Hare Hare, Rama Rama Hare Hare Hare, Rama Rama Hare Hare Hare.
We begin this night now with worship to our Lord. He's called Bajranga Bali. He's called Maruti. He's called Pavana Putra. We've taken this stand to take our Lord throughout the length and breadth of this beautiful nation. For He is the Lord who has the ability to protect us. He is the one who will allow us to build our faith, our confidence in His name and in His form. Tonight in our message, we will see His strength. We will see His purpose. We will see His power. And as we begin this night to invoke His energy, we must join in 40 verses of Sri Hanuman Chalisa.
Shri Guru Charana Saroja Raja Nijamana Mukura Sudha वरनौ रघुवर विमल जसु जोदायक फलचा बुद्धिहीन तनु जानिके सुमिरौ पवन कुमार बल बुद्धि विद्या देहु मोहि हरहु कलेश विकार।
पवन सुत हनुमान की जय।
जय बजरंग बलि हो। हनुमान ज्ञान गुण सागर, जय कपीश दिहु लोक उजागर, राम दूत तुलित बल धामा, अंजनी पुत्र पवन सुत नामा, महावीर विक्रम बजरंगी, कुमति निवार सुमति के संगी, कंचन वरन विराज सुवेशा, कानन कुंडल कुंचित केसा, महावीर बलवंता महावीर बलवंता, जय हनुमान महावीर बलवंता, पवन पुत्र हनुमान,
जय श्री हनुमान।
वस्त्र और ध्वजा विराजय, कांधे मोच जनेऊ साजय, शंकर सुवन केसरी नंदन, निज प्रताप महाजगवंद, विद्यावान गुणी अति चातुर,
आतुर राम काज करबे को आतुर प्रभु चरित्र सुनिबे को रसिया राम लखन सीता मन बस्य महावीर भगवता महावीर बलवंता जय हनुमान महावीर बलवंता पवन पुत्र हनुमान रूप धरिसि अहि दिकावा विकट रूप धरि लंक जरा भीम रूप धरि असुर संहारे रामचंद्र के कार सवारे लाए सजीव नलकन जियाय श्री रघुवीर हरषियुर लाय रघुपति कीने बहुत बराय तुम मम प्रिय भरत सम भाई महावीर बलवंता महावीर बलवंता हनुमान महावीर बलवंता पवन पुत्र हनुमान जय बजरंग बली सहस वदन तुम रोज सगावे अस कहि श्रीपति कंत लगावे जनकादिक ब्रह्मादि मुनीश नारद शारद सहित हीसा यम कुबेर दिगपाल जहाते कवि को अविद कह सके कहाते तुमो पुकार सुग्रीव के ना राम मलाय राज मर दिना महावीर बलवंता महावीर बलवंता जय हनुमान महावीर बलवंता पवन पुत्र हनुमान तुमरो मंत्र विभीषण माना लंकेश्वर भय सब जग जान युग सहस्र योजन पर बानो लीलो ताही मधुर पल जानो प्रभो मोद्र का मिली मुख माही जल दिलांगी गय चर जनाई दुर्गम काज जगत के जेते सुगम अनुग्रह तुमरे तिथि महावीर बलवंता महावीर बलवंता जय हनुमान महावीर बलवंता पवन पुत्र हनुमान जय श्री हनुमान तुम रखवारे उतना आज्ञा बिन पैतार सब सुकल है तुम्हारी शरणा तुम रक्षक का हो को डरना आपन तेज समारो आपे तीनों लोक हम कते कापे उत पिशाच निकट नहीं आवे महावीर महावीर जब नाम सुनावे महावीर बलवंता महावीर बलवंता जय हनुमान महावीर बलवंता पवन पुत्र हनुमान जय हो नास रोग हरय सब पीरा जब निरंतर हनुमत वीर संकट दे हनुमान चुरावे मन तम वचन ध्यान दुहलावे सब पर राम तपस्वी राजा तिनके काज सकल तुम साजा और मनोरथ जो कोई लावे सोई अमित जीवन पल पावे महावीर बलवंता महावीर बलवंता जय हनुमान महावीर बलवंता पवन पुत्र हनुमान
ऑल सैल्यूटेशंस टू महावीर स्वामी
चारो युग परताप तुम्हारा है पर सिद्ध जगत उजियार साधु संत के तुम रखवारे असुर निकंदन राम दुलारे अश से दीनव निधि के दाता सवर दीन जान की माता राम रसायन तुम्हारे पासा सदा रहो रघुपति के दाता महावीर बलवंता महावीर बलवंता जय हनुमान महावीर बलवंता पवन पुत्र हनुमान जय श्री हनुमान तुम
हमारे भजन राम को पावे जन्म जन्म के दुख बिसरावे अंत काल रघुबर पुर जाए यह जन्म हरि भक्त कहाए और देवता चित नजर ही हनुमत से सर्व सुख करही संकट कटे मिटे सब पीरा जो सुविराय हनुमत बल धीरा महावीर बलवंता महावीर बलवंता जय हनुमान महावीर बलवंता पवन पुत्र हनुमान ऑल ग्लोरी टू लॉर्ड हनुमान जी जय 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 हनुमान गुसाई कृपा करो गुरुदेव की नाई जो शत बार पाठ कर कोई तुत ही बंदी महा सुख होई जो यह पर हनुमान चलीसा हुई सिद्धि साची गौरी सा प्रतिदा सदा हरि चेरा की जय नाथ हृदय महादेव महावीर बलवता महावीर बलवंता हनुमान महावीर बलवंता पवन पुत्र हनुमान जय 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 हनुमान महावीर बलवंता पवन पुत्र हनुमान 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 पवन तनय संकट हरण मंगल मूरति रूप राम लखन सीता सहित हृदय वसहु सुरभो पवन सुत हनुमान की जय बजरंग बली की As we begin this beautiful night in devotion, while we must pay our respects to none other than Mahavir Swami, you're about to join in our wonderful chant to Ad Shakti Durga Devi Mata. First and foremost, as we praise the mother's name and the mother's form, to those who can remember really well the kahani from last night, as we continue tonight, Bajrang Bali, he's called Maruti, he's a child, and at a very tender age as a child, he loves to eat in our scripture. It is said everything he would do, every turn and every twist that he would make, he wants to eat. And last night we asked all devotees, how many people think you have an appetite like Maruti? Maruti loved to eat anything that he would see, any fruit, any dish that he saw the mother had. Ma, I'm hungry. He's always hungry. And the mother wants to take him to the river. And he's saying, Ma, before we go to the waters, can we walk with a little basket of fruits because I'll get hungry. And the mother says, sure, let's walk with it. And while he feels the love towards his mother, tonight, let's feel the love towards Ad Shakti Durga Devi.
Om Narayani Om Narayani Om Om Narayani Om Narayani Om Jai Jagadambe Ma Durga Jai Jagadambe Madurga Jai Jagadambe Madurga Jai Jagadambe Madurga
Aaj Shakti Durga Bhavani Mata Ki
Everybody loudly Jai Jagadambe Jai Jagadambe
Altogether,
Om Narayani Om Narayani Om
Sabko
Om Narayani Om Narayani Om Narayani Om
Bolo
Jaya Jagadambe Ma Durga Jaya Jagadambe Ma Durga
Thank you.
जगदम
जय जगदम्बे जय जगदम्बे माँ दुर्गा जय जगदम्बे माँ दुर्गा जय जगदम्बे जय जगदम्बे माँ दुर्गा जय जगदम्बे माँ दुर्गा
अम्बे माँ
जगदम्बे जय जगदम्बे जय जगदम्बे माँ दुर्गा जय जगदम्बे माँ दुर्गा जय जगदम्बे माँ दुर्गा जय जगदम्बे माँ दुर्गा
नारायणी ओ नारायणी ओ
जय जगदम्बे माँ दुर्गा जय जगदम्बे माँ दुर्गा। या देवी सर्वभूतेषु दुर्गा रूपेण संस्थिता नमस्तस्य 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 नमो नमः।
एवरीबडी
जयंती मंगला काली भद्रकाली कपालिनी दुर्गा क्षमा शिवदात्रे स्वास्वधा नमोस्तुते।
आज शक्ति दुर्गा देवी माता की बजरंग बली की जय।
In all scriptures, my dear friends, we continue with our kahani from last night. And as we do continue at this point in time, we are about to now see the glories of Lord Hanumanji as a child. When Bhagwan Sri Ramachandra was a child, he had his childhood days. When Bhagwan Sri Krishna was a child, he was called Balakrishna. In his childhood days, he showed the world all his tricks and all the little kahanis, the pastimes that we would have loved them for, because as long as they start growing up now, their life takes a different course, just like children. When children are small, they have a different katha, they have a different course, they have a different way of life. They say simple things and they make us laugh. They think in many different little ways that you won't even think about, and you say, but wait, I didn't even see it like that. They see things on a different light, on a different scale, and us, we can't even see it because we are now the adults thinking in one direction. Bajrangabali, Maruti, his name is called Maruti as a child. And while he's going with his mother to the river, the mother says, she says, son, we are going to the river. I need to take bath. You will have to now find things to do. So come on, bring your basket of fruits and let's go. So imagine a little child now holding his basket of fruits. And he is now as though he can fall down. He's now rumbling from side to side with his basket of fruits. But he wants to take it because he knows when time to eat, he's ready to eat. So he holds on to his basket of fruits and he goes with the mother. He places down the basket of fruits by one huge tree. And there now, not too far off, the mother is about to take a bath. So she walks along the path and she goes into the water. And while he's standing there, he's looking at the trees that are around. There are mango trees, there are fruit trees, there are different fruit trees that are around. And he's looking at these trees and he's now wondering, wow, look at these fruits. Some are different to mine. Some are looking big, some are looking small. Some have different shapes, some have different colors. And he's attracted as a child. Children are attracted by different shapes and colors, not so. Children are attracted by many bright colors or different colors. When they see a color, they want to grab for it. If a child sits and you're doing a Havan Puja and the fire starts, that child is ready to touch. He wants to put his hand. Something is looking dazzling and bright and nice. If you place something glittering, if you place something goldish like the stage, that child is ready to get there. He wants to feel it. He wants to touch it. If you show the child a piece of jewelry, the child wants to hold it and touch and feel because it's dazzling in the eyes of the child. Whatever dazzles, the eyes of the child want to grab it. Maruti, he goes with his mother. And the mother says, Maruti, bring your basket here so you could eat while I'm taking bath. And he places down the basket not too far and he wanders with the mother. And he says, Ma, don't worry, I'll be fine. And he goes and he sits on the banks of that river. She's taking her bath and he's now playing with the dirt. He's playing with a little pebble. He will take one and he will throw it into the water. He will take another and he will throw it and it will make a sound. Gloop. And he will enjoy that sound. He will take the stone, that pebble, and he will throw it. And like us, when we throw water, and sometimes on the water, we see it bouncing. And he will start finding little things to do. A child finds things to do that will make him or her happy. In our scripture, it tells us, according to the philosophy behind it, we must understand that we need to find things to make ourselves happy. We need to know what makes ourselves happy and we need to hold on to it. It could be what in our lives. It could be our mother. For a child, a mother is everything in the world. For a child, a mother is everything. The child will hold on to mother and that makes the child happy. For some, father. For some, a toy. You see a child hold a toy in his or her hands and you take that toy from the child, what happens? Cry, right? The child will cry out for a long time until he gets back that toy. In life, my friends, we must look for the simple things that make us happy. Some people go too far. We go to the extent where we want all the grandest of things in the world And in the end, these same things bring sorrows to us. It is the simple moments. It is the simple things. It is the simple words that are spoken sometimes that can make people smile, that can make people happy, that can make people contented. Hanumanji, Maruti, he sits there and he throws a rock and the rock is bouncing off and he's playing with that. But now he's starting to become hungry. So he gets up and he's walking towards his basket. He goes by the basket and he picks up a fruit and he's biting off the fruit. But while he's biting, he's looking up and he's wondering, mommy's taking bath. And then suddenly he spots now different mangoes on a tree. So he says, Ma, have you seen these nice big fruits on this tree? Can I have it? The mother turns around once and she says, okay, go, climb up, go ahead. So he starts to climb up the tree and he's picking these mangoes. He cannot hold together. He's a child. He's small, but he's flexible and he can move. Children at a very tender age, they are flexible. I was watching a documentary recently and children who are recently born, I think probably less than a year, they take them and throw them in a whole pool. And in no time, the child floats up and starts to grab on its own. And automatically, in no time, that child starts to swim. I hope my mother never do me that. But from baby, they teach them like this. From small, you teach them how to, they teach them how to swim by simply just throwing them into the water. When a child is born, as a matter of fact, on the 6th day or on the 12th day of birth of that child, there's a little offerings and prayer and worship that is done. And then as we call them, the midwife comes home to rub the baby, 6th day and 12 days. And on that day, either the 6th or either the 12th day, they hold on to the baby now, and now they decide, or they would call the father or the mother, and they will throw up the child in the air. You'll ever see that? Mommy ever do that? You scared? So many of the mothers, when they reach that part now, they say, no, not my child, go and throw yours. Because they have to take the child and throw the child in the air and catch back the child. And many people say, no, I'm not going to do my child that. Why? What is the purpose of that? What? I'm not going to do that. But you know what? When you take that baby that is 12 days old and you throw the baby in the air, it is said in mid-air while the child reaches at the highest peak, that child becomes scared for a moment and tries to grab on to something. But there's nothing to grab because the child is in the air. It is said automatically the senses start kicking in. It is a process. The senses start kicking in, and while the child starts to grab and there's nothing, that child starts to realize, and within that moment he falls back into the hand of mother or father. But the child realizes that I don't know when I would fall. So from this point I need to gain independency. I need to gain a form of independence in my mind. So I would not hold on to anything, but I will need to start detaching fast. Because in life I will need to stand on my own. You see, everything has a meaning. Ask why. It awakens the mentality of the child. It awakens the mode or the mind, the mentality in which that child would think from that moment for the rest of his or her life. Such a child will grow up to be brave. Such a child will stand up and be ready to take risks. Because he or she would understand, you know what? Don't worry, I could stand on my own 2 feet. I don't need anybody. Just by simply giving them that first moment of being confident. Maruti climbs up the tree. And when he climbs up that tree, he picks a few mangoes. He's a child. He might slip. He might fall. But you know what? He's trying and he's holding on to one or two in his hand and he's still trying to come down with the other hand. Trying to find his way down. Veera Maruti, Gambira Maruti. While he's a child, his power is powerful. He's strong. He's confident. Everybody? Veera Maruti, Gambira Maruti. Veera Maruti, Gambira Maruti. Veera Maruti, Gambira Maruti. Veera Maruti, Gambira Maruti. Ati Veera Maruti, Gambira Maruti. Veera Maruti, Gambira Maruti. While he sees mangoes, Some would look yellow in color, some would look orange in color, some are green in color. He goes and he picks a few and he comes down and he sits down and he starts to peel them. Now he's to take him by his mouth and he starts to peel them. He's Vanaru, he's monkey form. He will sit there and he's trying to peel them. Some are hard, he doesn't have the teeth with strength yet, but he's trying to pull them. Some he will smash at the ground and he will start to open them so that he could get what he has to eat. And as Maruti as a child, he's partaking of his fruits. But at that moment, it is said, he decides to look up to see while he's still eating. He looks up and then he sees now something looking like that orange color. It is looking bigger than all the other mangoes on the tree. It is looking so bright with a nice aura. And this is what he wants. This is the mango that he wants. He pauses now and he starts to wipe his hands. Ma, kya baat? Hare maiya! And he starts to wipe his mouth. He sees something different now. And he stands up. Bolo.
Veera Maruti, Gambira Maruti. Veera Maruti, Gambira Maruti. Ati Veera Maruti, Ati Veera Maruti. Veera Maruti, Ambira Maruti, Ati Veera Maruti, Ati Veera Maruti, Ati Veera Maruti.
Bajrangbali ki. He sees something bigger than usual. This has to be an extraordinary, an exceptional, and a different one. Ma, hare ma, dekho na. Look at that one. Ma, can I go for that one? Are jao na. She's taking care of herself. She's bathing. She's taking her bath. She's not concerned about you. Go ahead. Now you play. You take what you want. You eat. Are ma, really? That one is so big. Are jao, Maruti. So Maruti, he starts to climb up the tree. He wants that fruit. And he climbs up the tree and he reaches to the edge, but he realizes it's too far. He can't reach it. Are ma, I can't reach it. Son, jao na. Okay. You want me go? I will go. Listen.
Ko nahi janata hai jag mein kabhi sankat mochan naam tiharo sankat mochan naam tiharo.
He says,
बाल समय रवि भक्ष लियो तब तीनों होलो का भयो नियारो ताही सो त्रास भयो जग को यह संकट का हो न जात न हारो देवन आने करी विनती तब चार दियो रवि कृष्ण निवारो को नहीं जानत है जग में कभी संकट मोचन नाम तिहारो.
He says, बाल समय रवि भक्ष लियो तब. रवि who? रवि is the sun. It is the sun that he's seeing. According to those who understand the Hanuman Ashtak, it says,
बाल समय रवि भक्ष लियो तब तीनों हो लोक भयो अंधियारो ताही सो त्रास भयो जग को यह संकट काहु न जात न तारो देवन आनी करी विनती तब चार दियो रवि कशनिवारो.
You know what? He decides to make the leap. He sprints from the end of the branch and he presses on it. The tree, my friends, the ends of the branch, they are bending, and he makes a leap. And with a leap, he's about to go into the air. And you could hear the wind now. You could hear the wind. Who will help him? Pitaji must come and help him. Vayudev starts to blow and the wind starts to blow. And the mother, she's concerned about taking her bath. And he's aiming now. He's aiming up to the sun, Bhagwan Suryanarayan Swami. And he doesn't pay attention to the world. How far is it? He doesn't know, but he doesn't care because he has the power to do it. He has the will to do it.
पवन सुत हनुमान की.
Do you know? while I was doing some of my research on this, do you know something so beautifully? Do you know what is the distance between the earth and the sun? The distance between the earth and the sun in different seasons and different periods. You see, when there are different seasons and season changes in the world, it varies a little bit here and there. But according to what I've checked, the distance between the earth and the sun goes to up to 94 million miles, which is approximately 152 million kilometers away. Think about that. You can't check that. But think about it, 152,000 kilometers away. It is only 2 centuries ago when scientists would have gone in depth with this part of looking as to the distance through light years and so on, through their measurements and through their apparatus and through all the different techniques that they would have used to find out this distance. How old is our scripture? How old is our Ramchandramanas? How old is our Sri Hanuman Chalisa? Well, think about it. Sahasravadana tumharo jasagave asakai shri pati kanta lagave yug sahasrayo jana parabhano leelyotahi madhura palajano. So beautiful. Our scriptures have been written so long ago. It is said Valmiki sat down at the very beginning when Prabhu Sri Ramachandra created the whole epic of Ramchandramanas. Not too long after, Valmiki sat down and started to write Ramchandramanas. And to pay glorification to Lord Hanumanji, he wrote the Sri Hanuman Chalisa to glorify that bhakta. Think about how long that is. Because after Dwapar Yuga, where Hanuman Chalisa has been done, thousands of years after Bhagwan Shri Krishna came on the earth in Dwapar Yuga, and then thousands of years after, then Kali Yuga has begun. And 2 centuries ago, scientists have found out that the sun, my friends, it's 152,000 kilometers away from the earth. Whereas in Hanuman Chalisa, Yoga Sahasra Yojana Parabhano. So to those who know the old Sanskrit, one yoga, Yoga Sahasra Yojana Parabhano. One yoga is 12,000 years. Think about it. One yoga is 12,000 celestial years. One sahasra, yoga sahasra, is 1,000 as well. And one yojana is 8 miles. Yoga sahasra yojana. Hanuman Chalisa. Yoga sahasra yojana equals parabhanu. Think about it, visualize it. Yoga sahasra yojana parabhanu. So let me tell you now, let me see how many people know what's good. 12,000 multiplied by 1,000 multiplied by 8. Yoga sahasra yojana is how much? Jai Narayana. It comes up to 96 million miles. Remember, one yojana is 8 miles. 96 million miles. 12,000 by 1,000 by 8. It's easy. 12 by 8. And then add all the zeros behind it. 96 million miles. 1 mile, according to scripture, is 1.6 kilometers. So now, 96,000 multiplied by 1.6 is how much? Then I look at scratch your head now. You know how much? 153 million kilometers to the sun. Hanuman Chalisa says, Yoga Sahasra Yojana Parabhanu. Valmiki sat down and wrote and he said, you know what? Yoga Sahasra Yojana Parabhanu. When Mahavir Swami was a child, he made a leap and he decided to go to the sun. And it was how far? Yoga Sahasra Yojana Parabhanu. It was 153 million kilometers away. And 2 centuries ago, scientists have declared that the sun is average 153 million kilometers away. Kya baat? How intense is our scripture? how precise is our scripture? How precise is our culture, our knowledge, our text? The blessings of the Divine Lord. Maruti decides to make his leap. And when he makes his leap, he's heading towards Bhagwan Suryanarayan Swami. Bhagwan Surya feels privileged, so he puts his hands together and he sees Maruti coming up his way. He knows the energy of Maruti. He knows the blessings of this divine child. He knows that one day he will change the world. So while he knows that, he puts his hands together. Om Bhurbhuvah Svaha Tat Savitur Varenyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Diyo Yona Prachodaya. Om Bhurbhuvah Svaha Tat Savitur Varenyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Diyo Yona Prachodaya. Savitur-varenyam Bhargo-devasya dhimahi Diyo yona prachodayat. Om Bhurbhuvah-svaha Tat Savitur-varenyam Bhargo-devasya dhimahi Diyo yona. Let me see all the hands tonight. Boliye sabko pyar. Glory to the Lord. By yourselves now, loudly. Om Bhurbhuvah Svaha Tat Savitur Bhargo Devasya. Kya va? Ek baar aur. Om Bhurbhuvah Svaha Tat Savitur Varenyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Diyo Yona Prachodaya. Jai Shri Hanuman. Om Bhurbhuvah Svaha Tat Savitur Varenyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Diyo Yona Prachodayat. 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 Everybody. Om Bhurbhuvah Svaha Tat Savitur Varenyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Diyo Yona Prachodayat. Pauna Suta Hanuman Ki Jai Bajrang Bali Ki. Maruti makes his leap and he's going towards Bhagwan Suryanarayan Swami. But while he's going towards the sun, at that moment, the mother has completed her birth. She gets up and she's about to dry her skin. And she turns around and she says, Maruti, come prepare yourself, time to go. And she looks around, Maruti. She looks on the tree. Are Maruti? She goes around the tree. She goes at the ends of the river. She goes to the other side. She comes back to the spot. She's seeing the basket of fruits. Hare. And when she looks up, Hare. Maruti is in the sky. Hare Maruti, auna. And she's calling her Lord to come back. But Maruti, he doesn't even look down. He's heading in one direction. And he's heading towards Bhagwan Suryanarayan Swami. Mother becomes scared. She starts to call out, Hare, somebody. And she's calling out for somebody to help. And while she's calling out, nobody's around. She calls out again and again and nobody's around. And she throws her clothes on very quickly and she runs back to her kutia. She runs back to the spot and she calls in the village. She calls the father. She calls Kesari. And when Kesari is called upon, friends and bhaktas, Kesari runs to the spot and he looks up into the sky and he sees Maruti heading in the direction. The wind is guiding him. The wind has him as though he's afloat and he's going towards Bhagwan Surya. But while he's going towards Bhagwan Surya, it is the moment in the whole world. It is said from Mahashi Puran, it is a moment in the world where Rahu, one of the 9 planets, he has been given a privilege and an authority by the hands and by the mouth of Lord Indra. That whenever there's a particular moon and a change of season, Rahu, you can go and you can eat the sun. Do you know who's Rahu? When there was a time of the churning of the ocean, in Devi Bhagavat it speaks of it, and in Mahashiv Puran it speaks of it. When there was a time where the ocean was churned, there were Rakshasas on one side, there were Devatas on the other side. They were churning the ocean. It is in that medium and that time where Mother Lakshmi emerged. But before Goddess Lakshmi emerged, it is said while churning, they had a fight and they were fighting as to who would get the celestial nectar when it comes out. It is said after Goddess Lakshmi came and the nectar came out of the ocean, one Rakshasa grabbed hold of that nectar, that pot, and he started to run. And when he started to run with the nectar, it is said whoever would have drank of that nectar would have lived forever, immortal, because it was the immortal nectar. So the Rakshasa grabbed onto the nectar and he started to run. In order to save the world, Bhagwan Vishnu raised his hands and he allowed that discus, he allowed that chakra to leave his fingers and he threw it at the head of that Rakshasa. When the Rakshasa realized that this chakra was coming his way to destroy him, he started to drink this nectar now. And when he poured some of it into his mouth, while some went from his mouth and his tongue and started to go down his throat, a little bit in his mouth and some halfway going down, the chakra came and beheaded him at that moment. And as soon as it beheaded him, he dropped the pot and his body fell to the ground. The head went one way, the body went the other. He was serpent-like because he was a Rakshasa. Because there was immortal nectar in his head, and there was immortal nectar in his body, a part of his body. His head remained alive, his body remained alive. He had the nectar of immortality. He was then casted out into the skies. You go into the skies and don't come back to the earth to give anybody trouble. And while he was casted out in the skies, he was then named Rahu and Ketu. Head Rahu, body Ketu. He was serpent-like. But he could have never satisfied his hunger or his thirst. So he went to Lord Indra, and Lord Indra says, as the head of all the gods, the king of all the gods, he says, it doesn't lose anything for me to tell you go and eat the sun, because all you have is a head. So you go and eat the sun, you're not going to disappear. So he will go at different intervals and he will try to eat at the sun or eat at the moon accordingly. But whenever he eats, if this were to be the sun or the moon and he decides to eat with the head, he doesn't have a body. So he will eat and the sun will come back out through the back, because he doesn't have a body. According to scriptures, every time Rahu decides to eat the sun or eat the moon, and you see the moon becomes dark and it starts to gradually come back bright again, what do you call that? An eclipse takes place. At that point, we have a solar eclipse or we have a moon eclipse. The moon or the sun disappears for a period of time. Every time we see an eclipse, know that Rahu is taking his part. So when an eclipse is taking place, what do we tell people? If somebody's about to bring a child, what do you tell them? Well, you keep walking. Don't sit down at all. Otherwise, it's trouble. If you sit down at any point, the ill effects, the negative effects, the negative planetary effects of Rahu will fall upon your child and upon your life. To those who understand that there may be an eclipse taking place, don't sleep at that period, at that time at all. Rahu will take effect into your life. What will Rahu do? He will make you spend money and he will come back. He will take money from your home. You realize things just coming and you just have to spend and spend and spend and it will never stay. Rahu brings about headaches, migraines that will last for years upon years. Rahu creates arguments and tension in your home and in your family, so you'll have fights and quarrels. When that takes place, there's too much arguments. Nobody could see eye to eye. When Rahu comes in your life, he affects your limbs. You start getting pain in your joints and so on. You start getting stomach problems. You start getting indigestion. You start getting acid reflux, stomach burns. When Rahu affects you, Jai Narayan, problem starts. Rahu was heading to the sun at that moment, and Rahu sees this Maruti coming up. He doesn't know who he is. Who is this Bandar coming here? I'm about to take the sun. That is mine. This is my period. This is my moment to eat the sun. Nobody should take this away from me. So he looks at that child and he sees the child coming with full force and the child is happy. But who could stop that child? He doesn't even know who the child is. But that child must be powerful to her, would have left the earth and come up to the skies. So Rahu turns around now scared. You know why? Because Maruti sees now he sees that serpent-like type form of the Rahu. And he finds it looking like a little worm. And like a child, he sees this little worm wiggling in the skies. And he, instead of going towards the sun, he starts to divert now. Are there? Look, something to play with. He sees Rahu and he diverts now and he's about to grab hold onto Rahu. But Rahu flees at that moment. And when he moves from that spot, when he flees from that spot, Rahu, my dear friends, he goes by the feet of none other than Lord Indra. Lord Indra gave him that boon. Lord Indra gave him a promise that only you will get the sun or you will get the moon and you will partake of it. So he goes by Lord Indra. Hare Lord Indra, haven't you seen what is taking place? You promised me that the sun will be mine. But who is that flying there? And when Lord Indra came out into the atmosphere, he saw this child heading, monkey face. And he's heading towards the sun. And he says, but I don't know who is this. Whose child is this? Why can't they control that child? So he goes unto his Airavata. Who is the Airavata? He goes unto his Rahana, his vehicle. The first thing I noticed when I entered this home today was what? Anybody heard me say anything? I said, tonight I'm going back home on top of the elephant. The Airavata is the elephant. Lord Indra's vehicle is the elephant. Lord Indra sat down on his elephant and he goes into the sky. He's in his space now and he's going towards Maruti. Maruti realized this worm-like individual left. He's about to go back to the sun, but then he see now an elephant and he say, "Are, I would love to sit on that elephant and get a ride now." He's a child. He's looking for things to do. He's anxious. He's excited about everything. Children are excited about anything you give them. You take something and you drop it and it makes a sound and I want to do it too. I want to try. I want to be a part of it. I want to do it. You get up and you walk in a particular way. Can I walk like you? Let me try too. Everything they're ready to try. Maruti, my dear friends, he's about to go to the elephant of Lord Indra. And when he reaches close by, Lord Indra realizes that his form is becoming bigger and bigger and powerful. He doesn't know what to do. He jumps off the elephant and who goes on top? Hari kya baat. Maruti Raya, Maruti Raya, Maruti Raya, Maruti Raya. Bajrangbali ki. He sits on the elephant. And he decides not to go in the direction of the sun. Maruti aya balabhima, bhaktala mele balprema. Maruti aya balabhima, bhaktala mere balprema. Maruti aya, Maruti aya, Maruti aya, Maruti aya. Hari, hey Maruti. Thank you.
ಅಂಜನಿ ಸುತನೆ ಆಂಜನೇಯ ಅಮಿತ ಪ್ರತಾಪಮ ಬಲರಾಯ ಮಾರುತಿಯಾಯ 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 ಮಾರುತಿಯಾಯ
ಹೇ ಮಾರುತಿ
ಶಿಷ್ಯನೇ ಸ್ವಪ್ರಕಾಶಿನಿ ಭದ್ರಕಾಯನಿ ವಂದಪಿ ನಿನಗೆ ಸೂರ್ಯ ಶಿಷ್ಯನೇ ಸ್ವಪ್ರಕಾಶಿನಿ ಭದ್ರಕಾಯನಿ ವಂದಪಿ ನಿನಗೆ ಮಾರುತಿಯಾಯ ಮಾರುತಿಯಾಯ ಮಾರುತಿಯಾಯ
That Maruti decides to go towards Bhagwan Surya. And while he's going towards his son, Indradev is upset. He's angry. And because he's angry, at that point, he decides to take out now his Vajra, his thunderbolt. And he says, "Today I will teach the world the strength of Lord Indra." When he takes it out, at that moment, Maruti is not concerned. He's going, he's riding on the elephant, he's having a good time. And he's going to Bhagwan Surya. And he looks down and he could peek at his mother, very minute, and his father. He could see the hands like this. Hare, come on. But you know what? He's a child, and in the moment he has been caught up, he's enjoying.
Maruti aaya bal bhima, bhaktara mere bal prema. Maruti aaya bal bhima, bhaktara mere bal prema. Maruti aaya.
Marutiyaya 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 Marutiyaya
Bajrangbali ki jai
Devotees of God Maruti is going towards Bhagwan Surya He's seated on the Airavata on the elephant and he's comfortable Can you imagine you wake up one day and you've seen a little monkey sitting on an elephant and going towards his son? Jai Bhagwan. The mother is down below and she's looking up and she's trying to call out, Hare Maruti, auna, vapas, come back. But he's not listening. He's enjoying the moment. He's caught in a moment of success. He's caught in a moment of happiness. It is a play. It is said when Maruti came into the world became a play for him. When Bhagwan Shri Krishna...
Shri Krishna Govinda Hare Murari He Nath Narayana Vasudeva
He Nath Narayana Vasudeva
Vasudeva
Bolin Shri Krishna Govinda to all those who are being a part of this wonderful Yajna tonight, all those who are here, to all those who are viewing via all the medias, take a moment and let us sing for the Divine Lord. Let us awaken the energy in our homes. Let us wake up the spark and the strength of Bhagwan Govinda, Bhagwan Krishna, sustainer of the entire cosmos. Lord, without you we cannot survive. Without you we are not sustained. Without you we cannot do anything, because everything has come from your energy and everything will go back to you as we say Om Shri Krishna Arpanam. Tonight, Lord, we are worshipping you. You are the one who has created the pastimes, the leelas of the world. And today as we are enjoying them, Lord, Shri Krishna Govinda Hare Murari Enata Narayana Vasudeva Enata Narayana Vasudeva Enata Narayana Vasudeva. At this time, Maruti is going closer to Bhagwan Surya. And when he almost reaches Bhagwan Surya, bhaktas, devotees, it is said something is about to happen. At this time, Maruti is getting closer to the sun. Rahu is standing in a distance, and there Lord Indra is standing in a distance as well. And they don't want this to happen, because Lord Indra has promised Rahu that it will be his opportunity. At the same time, Lord Indra wants back his Airavata, he wants back his elephant. So he takes the thunderbolt in his hand and he's about to raise it in the air and he's about to aim at Maruti. But before he would release, suddenly the wind becomes too much. Suddenly the wind becomes, my friends, too much, too strong, too powerful. And dear Lord Indra, he can't understand why the wind is too powerful. The wind is dazzling him. It is as though there's dust in the air and he cannot recognize. He cannot see further to a point and he's trying to understand. And then suddenly in front of him stands none other than Pawandev, Vayudev. Vayudev is standing in front of Lord Indra and he puts his hands together, heart to Jodhakar. And he says, please, please, this is my child. He's a child, he's only a child. Please. And Lord Indra says, a child? If he's a child and he could have left the earth and reached so far, I can't imagine when he gets big what he will do. You need to control him now. And he's about to raise that Airavata. And there Vayudev puts his hands together and he says, Maaf kijiye na, please forgive us. He's only my child, do not hurt him. He's very soft, he's very tender. The love that I have for my child as a father, nobody would understand. Please don't do this. But filled with ego, filled with ahankar, filled with, my friends, with anger, with a rage, without thinking twice, he lifts, my friends, that thunderbolt in the air and he releases it as fast as he can. And while the thunderbolt is going, the mother is looking at her son. Kesari is looking at his son. Pawandev turns around and he bends his head and he places his hands above. It is said a teardrop is about to fill his eyes because he knows it might be the worst. And suddenly the thunderbolt is about to strike at Maruti. And as soon as it hits Maruti, he gains on consciousness. He falls off the Airavata and from high above in the air, he starts to fall and he's coming down to the earth. And Pawandev, it is said, becomes angry. Like a tornado in the atmosphere, the wind starts to whirl. It starts to curve in a circular motion. And he's about to grab his son. Shri Rama Jai Rama Jai Jai Rama Shri Rama Jai Rama Jai Jai Rama Ho. The mighty child, the powerful child that the world has waited to see. He has been struck by a thunderbolt and he's falling to the earth. Shri Rama Jai Rama Jaya Jaya Rama Shri Rama Jai Rama Jaya Jaya Rama.
Shri Rama Jai Rama
Jai Jai Rama Shri Rama Jai Rama
The whole universe has become sad because a child has energy, a child is vibrant, a child is filled with so much of power and there he falls and when the thunderbolt hits him, he falls off the Airavata and he's coming, falling to the earth and the father becomes upset, he's hurt, but he's in pain. It is said as the wind god, he starts to swirl like a tornado to capture his son. And while he's capturing his son, he grabs onto his child in his hand and he hugs him tight and he holds on to him. He looks at the world and angry, he says, the world has witnessed my son. The world has seen where my son has been struck. And nobody did anything. The world will feel the pain and the power at the same time of Vayudev. It is said Vayudev, he takes a deep breath. He says, I warn you, Indra. He's just a child, but the world will see the pain of Vayudev today. A father, when he's hurt, no one wants to see a child hurt. He says today the world will witness the strength of a father.
Shri Rama Jai Rama Jaya Jaya Rama Shri Rama Jai Rama Jaya Jaya Rama Shri Rama Jai Rama Jaya Jaya Rama Shri Rama Jai Rama Jaya Jaya
One voice.
Shri Ram Jai Rama Jaya Jaya Rama Shri Ram Jai Rama Jaya Jaya Rama Shri Ram Jai Rama Jaya Jaya Rama Shri Ram Jai Rama Jaya
It is said Vayudev, he takes a deep breath and he inhales. And he's the wind god. When he inhales, it is said like winds coming all together, all the air of the universe is then consumed within the body of Vayudev. He is the lord of air. He's the lord of wind. He's the lord, my friends. He will show the world the strength. When he inhales, he holds on to his child and he pulls all the air together. No one can survive without air. And he goes down to the spot where the mother stands there. Anjani Ma, she holds onto her heart and she's crying. My child, my putra, would somebody do anything? Why didn't you stop them, Vayudev? And Vayudev says, my heart is hurt at this moment, Ma. I will take him out of this world. Leave him in my care. And I promise you I will bring him back. At that very moment, he goes to the nether regions, he goes to Patal, and he goes in a little cave by himself, and there he stands there and he holds on to his child, and he takes with him all the air of the universe, all the wind of the universe. Birds are flying but they start falling from the sky because there's no wind to glide them. There's no air for people to breathe, even in the heavens the devatas they cannot breathe anymore. There's no air to breathe. People on the earth, they start holding their stomach. They can't breathe. Their chest, they're struggling to breathe. There's no air. It is said in the skies, the devatas, their stomach is starting to shrink because there's no air for them to breathe. And now, Lord Brahma, Bhagwan Vishnu, they realize that they must do something about it. So what would they do? They're about to leave their space and their spot in Vaikunth and Brahmaloka, and they're about to come down.
Shri Rama Jai Rama Jaya Jaya Rama Shri Rama Jai Rama
जय जय राम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम
क्या बात अ फादर इज हर्ट ही गोज इनटू द केव एंड ही होल्ड्स ऑन टू हिज चाइल्ड एंड ही स्टार्ट्स टू क्राई एंड द टीयर्स आर फ्लोइंग फ्रॉम हिज आईज एंड इज फॉलिंग ऑन टॉप ऑफ द हेड ऑफ हिज चाइल्ड And he says, today, I don't care about nobody. I don't care about the world. Let the world know that they've hurt me today. And the world will feel the brunt of what you did. Mothers are great. Our mothers are powerful. Our mothers, they give us strength and they give us energy. But fathers will stand up when it comes to true business. Fathers will stand up and they will be the backbone when there's a need to. He will raise his voice when there's a need to. He will stand firmly when there's a need to. While we were growing up, we know we could go by mommy and ask she anything, but daddy, now we have to think twice before we go by he would. You have to think twice because he is a serious person. But nobody knows the softness of the heart of a father. He stands and he looks at the child saying, mommy, mommy, hugging mommy, staying with mommy, doing everything with mommy. But he simply looks on and he says, you know what, don't worry. I will do what it takes to make sure.
Mera ghar ta kale kale chahi tiya java udasi jeevan ta sona sona hai asti pyasi pyasi तेरे अंते ही खुशिया से भर गया ये जीवन सारा मेरा नाम करेगा रोशन जग में मेरा राज दुलारा
The father, he looks at his child and he's hurt. He takes all the air. Lord Brahma, Lord Vishnu, they're searching everywhere. Everybody, they're searching for Vayudev. And nobody could find him. He has gone to Patal, nether regions. Everybody are looking for Maruti because they know now people will die, the world will be destroyed. Without air, even the planets and the stars and universe will start now becoming imbalanced. Because the lore of air in itself keeps them up. Brahmadev, he uses his vision. And he closes his eyes and there he spots the spot or the place in which Vayudev is standing. Vishnu Prabhu, let us go down there. We need to go down Patal. And in the meantime, a father is sulking for the loss of his child. He sits down now. He places him on his lap. And listen.
Tujhe suraj kaho yah chanda Tujhe deep kaho तारा मेरा नाम करेगा रोशन जग में मेरा राज दुलारा
Tonight, my dear friends. Fathers are important. They are powerful. They will stand up for us when there's a need to be. So if your father is alive, think of him in your mind. Say, Lord, protect my father. Bless my father. Because when I need him, he will be there. And to those who have lost a father, it may be too late now. But while you're sitting here, or while you're tuned in, simply say a prayer in your mind and say, Lord, wherever my father may be, wherever his soul may be, protect him. Show love in his life. If he has taken rebirth, may he be happy and comfortable. I'm praying for him right now. And if he hasn't taken rebirth, maybe he's in your hands, Lord. Protect him. Tonight, while we sing this beautiful one, to the members of the home and the family who are here, I want you to take the RT and go by Daddy. Tonight we must honor our Father, who would have stood up for us to be who we are today because everything happens by the grace of our parents. But with this bhajan, respect your Father. Love your father. To those who are here tonight or to those who are tuned in, if you haven't spoken to your father in a long time, give him a call. Say, Dad, you know what? I was just thinking about you. I miss you. Are you okay? Sometimes all they need is a checkup. Sometimes all they need is a reminder just to know that they are alive and just to know that they are appreciated. Take a moment, send them a message, give them a call, and simply say, Dad, I miss you.
मैं कब से तरस रहा था मेरे आंगन में कोई केले न नहीं सी के बदले मेरी सारी खुशियाँ ले ले तेरे संग झूला रहा है मेरे बाहों में जग सारा मेरा नाम करेगा रोशन जग में मेरा राज दुलारा आज उंगली तान तुझे मैं चलना सिखलाओ कल हाथ पकड़ना मेरा जब मैं बुहार हो जाओ तू मिला तू मैंने पाया जीने का नया सहारा मेरा नाम करेगा रोशन जग में तुझे सूरज कहो या चंदा तुझे दीप कहो या तारा मेरा नाम करेगा रोशन जग में मेरा राज दुलारा
वृंदावन बिहारी लाल की
The father handed on to his child.
Not too long after, Brahmadev and Bhagwan Vishnu, they came down and they found his spot and they entered now the cave in which he was standing.
And they approached him and they put their hands together. Vayu, we understand what had happened. Please release the air from within you. The world will be destroyed if you don't give back air to the world.
It is said while they were speaking to him, all the other devatas, they started to assemble. They started to come down because nobody could survive. Even the devatas were holding their tummy. Their lungs were shrinking. They couldn't breathe anymore.
And all of them, they were coming. While they were all coming, they stood in midair and they're about to speak now to none other than Vayu. Are Vayu? If you don't give back air to the world, the people of the world will be destroyed. Please listen to us. Please be kind to us. Please understand that we need the air. We will do what we can to bring Fatiha child back into the world. And then Brahmadev walked up to this child and he looked at him.
And he saw the jaw was broken. He saw that his jaw was broken, was cracked, and it was broken right in front of him.
He says, Maruti.
At that point, it is said Lord Indra came down and he looked at him.
He says, no. Maruti, no. He says, today, he's known to be the one with the broken jaw. In Sanskrit, Hanu means broken jaw. Today, he will be powerful. He will be called Hanuman. He will be called Hanuman. And while we give him this name, Brahmadev, please bring forth life. Brahmadev, he walks up to the child and he takes his hands and he touches the head of the child. When suddenly now, he's seeing a little finger movements, very small. He's seeing finger movements. Everybody, they are looking on. All the devatas, they are looking down.
Bhagwan Vishnu, he blows with his mouth, he blows his sacred air, Pran Pratishta, and he's about to bring forth life back into this child. This will be no ordinary child, but this will be a divine child, he says. Lord Indra took at that moment, he took a garland from around his neck made out of lotus flower, and he walks up to the child and he places it around the baby neck of the child, and he says, bring life into this child, Brahmadev. And suddenly the eyes are about to begin to wink. The eyes, they're about to open, and as soon as the eyes open at that point, he looks at everyone and he smiles. He doesn't know what is taking place. He doesn't know what had happened, but he smiles and he says, Are kya hua? And all the gods walk up to him. It is that Bhagwan Surya in his original form, he comes down and raises his hands and he says, Hanuman, today I will bless you. Today I will bless you with 100th of my brilliance and my strength and my power. You'll be known, renowned around the world. It is said Varuna, the god of water, walked up to him and he says, Maruti, water will never drown you. Water will never harm you. I bless you as the god of water, where water will never touch you. Agnidev, he walks up to Hanumanji. He says, Putraha, you don't know your strength and you don't know your power, but today I bless you, and not even fire will scratch your skin. I bless you that fire will never touch you. It is said Lord Kuber, Lord Kuber, the god of wealth, says you're the most mighty and most powerful one, and today I will give you a gift. He says, today I am Kuber and I hold the gada. Today I will give you this gada, and you take this gada and you go around the world and you use it wherever you want to. And I give you my word that as long as you use this, you will be protected with my strength and my power. Nobody will be able to touch you. Maruti, today you are known as Hanuman. Bhagwan Shankar, he comes down. And there it is said, he stamps his trishul on the earth. And as soon as he stamps it, he says, child, today you will be called Chiranjeevi. You will never die from this moment. Nobody will be able to destroy you. No weapon will be able to harm you. No one can pull you down. You will never get ill. You will never get sick. Brahmadev says, I bless you with my Brahmashtra, Vishwakarma. It is said, the architect of all the weapons, he says, no weapon will scratch your skin. And Lord Vishnu says, child, I bless you. Your purpose will be successful. I can't wait to enter the world. I can't wait to meet with you so that we can create the pastimes of the world, because the world is waiting for you, Lord. And he stands up there and he holds his gada, and all the gods, they started showering flowers upon him. And while the flowers are falling on his head, at that point in time, they started now blowing the shank. They started now ringing the celestial bells, and they are placing flowers, because now the birth of a new child, Hanumanji, has come into the world. Pavana Sudha Hanuman ki, Bajrangabali ki jai, Bajrangabali ki. And he looks at everybody. He sees the face of everybody standing there. And you know who he looks for? Ma? Ma kao? Where's my mother? All that blessing you just get. Jai Narayan. Powerful Maruti. Everybody worships him. And he says, Alia move aside. Ma? Because his mother is his strength. His mother is his power. It says,
Hanuman aisa ki lanka jaiye, aur sang Lakshman se bhai, jal ke angne mein puja parega, kotin gin ka rai. Are Meghnad aisa putra hamara, Kumkaran aisa se bhai, घर महाऊंगी मंदिर में से वो टप से दो भाई हरे राम काज की जाइए तज पल पूजन आश देश पुरुषार्थले हरे पुतले हनुमान मानो मानो
क्या बात
मानो मानो असुर मोरे सीत सिया के देखे राम को मिलो मानो मानो असुर मोरे सीत सिया के देखे राम को मिलो मानो 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 असुर मोरे सीत सिया के देखे राम को मिलो
कहे मंदोदरी सुनो पिया रावण के क्या कुमति कमाल जिनके जान की तू हर लाए वो तपसी दो भाई अरे लंका साई को तो हमारा रत्नागिर से काई गिरलास की चौकी तारे भागे जो धोबी कर भाई मानो मानो असुर मोरे सीत से आके राम को मिलो मानो मानो असुर मोरे सीत से आके दिखे राम को मिलो मानो मानो हनुमान ऐसा की लंका जाइए और संग लक्ष्मण जीवन के काए जल के अग्नि में पूजा परेगा और को दिन को राय मेघनाथ ऐसा हमारा पुत्र ही हनुमाना कुंभकर्ण ऐसा भाई गे दूंगरी तुम्हारा वो को कोलार का दे पेरे सुपाई दो तभी वो तब से दो भाई मानो 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 असुर मोरे सीत सिया के देखे राम को मिलो मानो मानो बंदर के लंका में आइए घर घर दूंगे चाई भाग की मनसी भी लंका कर जोरा जोरा कर पूछे कुर जाई अब तो क्या दर का मांद मंदर डोरा पीहर रूप की ग्याई मैं हरनी से हमारा हर नारी तू ना हर कबा बर राई मानो 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 असुर मोरे सीत सिया के दिखे राम को मिलो मानो 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 असुर मोरे सीत सिया के देखे राम को मिलो मानो मानो असुर मोरे सीत सिया के देखे राम को मिलो मानो मानो असुर मोरे सीत सिया के देखे
प्रेम सुषमापति महादेव की जय बजरंग बली की
मारुति माय डियर फ्रेंड्स ही गॉट अप एट दैट मोमेंट एंड ही फर्स्ट पर्सन ही आस्क्स फॉर मा एंड ही डजंट सी हिज मदर So he decides now, he says, Vayu, I'm going back down to the earth. Devatas, I'm going back down to the earth. And he picks up his little gada. And he starts to head back to the earth now. But while he's going back down to the earth, he's seeing as a child so mischievously. He's seeing moments in which he can create his own destiny. He's going down and he's powerful. So the kahani says, with so much power, he becomes miserable now. When a child has power, they start using that wall. How? He's coming down, and while he's going down, he passes the mountains, and he's going down. On top of a mountain, he sees one sadhu in meditation. So he lands on top of the mountain now. And he looks at him. Hare. Sadhu doesn't move. He takes his hands and he passes it by the eyes. I wonder if he could see anything, boy. Sadhu is in meditation, he doesn't know anything. So he goes behind him, and he stretches out his arm, and he pulls the beard now, and as soon as he pulls and he yanks at the beard, he runs around and he goes down the mountain. At that point, the Swami opens his eyes, and when he sees Maruti, he says, Hare, I will get you. What can he do? Maruti has gone. You can't catch him. He was blessed by Pavandev, his father, to be faster than the wind himself. It is said, Garuda came that day, and Garuda is that huge bird, the Vahana of Lord Vishnu. He flies so swiftly. It is said, combining the speed of Garuda and combining the speed of Pavandev put together, Maruti was given that speed and that strength. You think you could catch him? He went down that Parvat, and going down now, he would see people of the village. He would see many devotees doing their tapasya. He would see many devotees doing their devotion. He would go wherever there was puja, and he would pick up their lota and he would run with it. He will go where there's a yajna and he will pick up their vessels and take their parasara and he will eat all the parasara and run because nobody can catch him. It says sometimes when you have too much power, you abuse it. God has given you the power of many different things to use, but we abuse it. You know what power we speak of? I always tell people, God has given you the hands to clap. When you're in a satsang, you clap. But you know what? In a satsang, people sit wrong zone.
Yeah, he's a small baba man. He can make me clap. People sit down on their prop. People sit down on their prop, the chin. God has given you the gifts, the power of the hands to clap. Instead, we look at people and we're ready to hit them. We're ready to pull them down. God has given you the lips, the voice, the avas to sing. Shri Rama Jai Rama. Jaya Jai Rama. Shri Rama Jai Rama. Jaya Jai Rama. Instead, we use the voice and we abuse people. We criticize people. We pull down people by saying bad things to them. Friends and bhaktas, God has given you the eyes to look at this beautiful murti. Have you taken a moment to glance at the wonderful form of God? Instead, some people, instead of looking at God, they come to see, I wonder how they dress up this place, right? I wonder where you put it on tonight. I wonder if they fixed the little corner that we see last time. They come to see trouble. They come to look for problems. They come to find, as we say, kuchur and problems. God has given you eyes to see the murti. God has given you the ear to listen to bhajan, sankirtana, and absorb the knowledge that you've received. Instead, we listen to gossip. You see, we have powers that God has given to us, but when we misuse it, we end up into the pits of negativity. Maruti, my dear friends, in our scripture, it is said, Pavanaputra, Sri Hanumanji, he goes down into the village, and there he's giving problems to everyone. And one sage, he's in meditation, and he's now like this, and his hand is propped on that stick, and he's holding the kamandalu. And when Hanumanji grabs the kamandalu, the Guruji, he's so swift, he grabs at the hand of Hanumanji. And as he holds on to him, he says, today you're not getting away. Today I will deal with you. Today you will learn a lesson, Hanumanji. You think that you're more powerful than everybody else, and you think that you can do what you want. But today I will teach you a lesson. And as he speaks to Hanumanji, tomorrow night we will continue with that message. Bajrangbali ki jai, Pavana Suta Hanuman ki jai. Tomorrow we will continue as Hanumanji is mighty and powerful, but as the Guru speaks to him, we listen to that dialogue as we continue through the golden pages of Sri Hanuman Ankh. Tonight, my dear friends, at this time we have a cake that is to cut. We want to invite members of the family to bring that cake forward as we're about to join in a celebration as well, where we celebrate 70 years of birthday, 17 years of, my friends, of a wonderful mother, Sumintra Meya. On behalf of the entire Basdev family, as we take this moment to do this dedication, we like to also extend Bhagwan's blessings to a wonderful brother who is celebrating his birthday next week as well, to Radha Ramanadas. We say Bhagwan's blessings to you. And it has been requested to perform this beautiful Hare Krishna chant to you. So we do this one as the birthday song. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Oh.
So all the devotees who've taken this moment to join with us tonight, we are sending love and blessings in your direction. Tonight to all the devotees who are locked on internationally as well, we say Bhagavan's blessings to you all. As wonderful brother Ravin Bodramji, Nareshji, Dwarka, we say Bhagavan's blessings to you. And to all the devotees of the mandir who are locked on, taking their blessings of Mahavir Swami. And to all the devotees throughout this beautiful world, as we touch the feet of Bhagavan Govinda, we join all together. So give her a round of applause.
Vrindavan Bihari Lal ki, Pavana Sudha Hanuman ki.
With this, my dear friends, this is where we invite all to stand as we all to now join in our beautiful Aarti.
आरती की जय हनुमान लला की दुष्ट दलन रघुनाथ कला के आरती की जय हनुमान लला की दुष्ट दलन रघुनाथ कला की
जय बजरंग बली
आरती
जाके बल से गिरिवार कापे रोग दोष जाके निकटन जाके जाके बल से गिरिवार कापे रोग दोष जाके निकटन जाके अंजनी 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 पुत्र महाबलदाई तन के प्रभु सदा सहाय देवी रघुनाथ पताए लंका जारी सियास भिलाए रघुनाथ पताए लंका जारी सिया सुधिलाए लंका से लंका से लंका से गोत समुद्र से कराए जात पवन सुत बार न लाए लक्ष्मण मूरचित परे सकारे आनी संजीवन प्राण उबारे लक्ष्मण मूरचित परे सकारे आनी संजीवन प्राण उबारी बैठी 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 पताल तोरी जमकारी अहि रावण की भुजा उचारे मुनि आरती उतारे जय 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 हनुमान उचारे सुनर मुनि आरती उतारे जय 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 हनुमान उचारे कंचन 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 तारक पुर लवचारी आरती करत अंजना माये
पिता त्वमेव त्वमेव बन्धुश सखा त्वमेव त्वमेव विद्या द्रविणं त्वमेव त्वमेव सर्वं मम देवदेव त्वमेव सर्वं मम देवदेव स्वामिनाथ सच्चिदानन्द जय गुरुनाथ सच्चिदानन्द स्वामिनाथ सच्चिदानन्द जय गुरुनाथ सच्चिदानन्द
Chidananda.
हम सब है तेरे बच्चे स्वामी, हम सब है तेरे बच्चे स्वामी, तू है हमारा विधाता स्वामी नाता, तू है हमारा विधाता स्वामी नाता।
जय बजरंग बली।
राधे राधे गोपाल राधे, राधे राधे गोविंद राधे राधे राधे, राधे राधे गोपाल राधे राधे राधे, राधे राधे गोविंद राधे राधे राधे, राधे राधे गोपाल राधे राधे राधे, राधे राधे गोविंद राधे राधे राधे, राधे राधे गोपाल राधे राधे राधे, राधे राधे गोविंद राधे राधे राधे, राधे राधे गोपाल राधे राधे राधे, स्वामी नाथा
सनातन धर्म की
जय जय सीताराम आसनित सब लोग दरअसल टेक आवर सीट्स।